manufacturing industries, which, as China closes its borders over COVID, becomes even more internationally relevant. Steve Eagle knows this space very, very well. He's the co-founder and director of howtobuyaustralian.com.au. Steve, welcome.
Great to be with you. Thanks for having me on.
Bubs Australia and A2, Steve, are just two brands this week that have made or are likely to make the big time in massive deals with the US. How can these two businesses act as a kind of template, a lead for other Australian businesses going forward?
Look, they're wonderful examples, and I think the real opportunity exists for both existing businesses, but also new entrepreneurs entering the business space with physical product manufactured in Australia. What we're seeing globally is a bit of a hangover from the COVID pandemic, with still ongoing supply constraints. Supply chains around the world are still suffering, and it's really at the raw materials and commodity materials side of the supply chain that these problems are happening. So this affects all of manufacturing. In my circle, we speak to a broad range of manufacturers. They touch every sector, and there is not a single person I've spoken to in the last 6 months who has said that they haven't had any trouble. Everybody's experiencing this. So in terms of making this a template, as you like, for Australian manufacturers to reach out to our well-known, trusted global partners, and just let them know that we're available. We have over 90,000 manufacturing businesses in Australia. We have a very high capability in terms of skill set and in terms of training. We know how to deliver products that are profitable, and that really sets a footprint for us to be a fantastic supplier globally.
Still on Bubs Australia, I like the way they were able to scale up their product very quickly to send 1.2 million tins of baby formula to the US. They're a local manufacturer. And with China bogged down over COVID lockdowns, how does that make Australian manufacturing a better business deal? Surely we're in a position to make the deal cheaper.
Yeah, we absolutely are. I mean, if you look at a country like China as a trade competitor, the cost of labour in China around the manufacturing sector has doubled in the last 8 years. And it's continuing to grow at about 12% year on year. So it's becoming more expensive, and it's also difficult. China still is operating under a zero tolerance policy. If they find COVID in a manufacturing sector or in a manufacturing region, that will shut that entire region down. So that's unreliable, and it's unpredictable. These are unreliable and unpredictable are two of the arch enemies of doing good production. You need stability and reliability, and that's something Australia has. You know, we've got a fantastic array of raw materials in Australia. We've got all the capability that we need to produce fantastic product. I guess the missing gap in Australian capability right now is in processing some of those raw materials. And I absolutely agree with you. I mean, this has gone beyond being a nice to have. I think it's really now a matter of national security that Australia starts to redevelop these in-house capabilities for us to transform our raw materials that we're so good at mining and so good at producing, and actually make them available to our 90,000 plus manufacturers for them to create great product.
I like this kind of talk. There is also some indication that the trade relationship between China and Australia might be back on next year. How hopeful are you that the new government can mend our trading ties?
Look, I think they will. The Labor Party have shown over the years that they're very friendly with China in many different ways. You can have a look into Dan Andrews and what he's been doing in Victoria and so on around the Belt and Road Initiative and setting up to take part in that. I don't necessarily think that's a bad thing, but we need to be pragmatic. There is absolutely a need for us to have a domestic capability, and I think we've learned over the last 2 years a very hard lesson in what happens when we don't have that capability. So it's really time now for Australia to focus at home and start delivering that.
And Steve, next week just happens to be Made in Australia Week. What can you tell us about that?
Look, it's Australia's premier manufacturing week next week with a trade show happening in Sydney. And all of our high-end and very advanced manufacturing capability will be on display there for the world to see. I'd really encourage anybody who's interested in Australian manufacturing just to have a look at that and rediscover our footprint. I think there's a big gap at the moment between the consumers and also the businesses producing product. They don't really know each other that well in Australia. Things like Alibaba, which point to Chinese manufacturers, have by far taken the fancy of entrepreneurs and businesses for their sourcing. Australia doesn't yet have something like Alibaba, but Australian Manufacturing Week is a great showcase of our capability, and you'll see all sorts of wonderful stuff there that I think will surprise a lot of people when they go looking for it.
Bring it on. Steve Eagle, Aussie Manufacturing.